All right, ladies and gentlemen, what a great turnout. It's nice to see you all here as we get ready for the official weigh-in for GLORY 49. GLORY 49 is going to wrap up a fantastic year for GLORY Sports International. Of course, there's no better place for us to do that than in the spiritual home of kickboxing back in Amsterdam. Let me just take a quick moment to say thank you. We are in the beautiful Steigenberger Hotel, and I want to say thank you to their staff for making us all comfortable here. It is our home away from home, and as long as I'm giving shout-outs at the end of the year here, I want to say something about the fantastic support staff of GLORY behind the scenes that work so hard. And this hotel gives us a great location for us to do all of our work in the final days leading up to the big event, of course, here in Amsterdam, and getting the stage set for these athletes to do what they do best. And what a stage it's going to be. An amazing week for GLORY as we go from a sold-out theater at Madison Square Garden in New York City to what will be a sold-out Ahoy in Rotterdam tomorrow night, equally as historic for this part of the world, and we are honored to be able to put kickboxing back inside that great venue. For more on what's coming tomorrow night and the broadcast schedule around the world, let me introduce the play-by-play voice of GLORY Sports International, Mr. Todd Grisham.
Thank you, Tim. I appreciate it. We're really excited to have our final big event of the year here in Holland, as we do every year. We will be live for the Super Fight Series Saturday, 1:30 p.m. Eastern Time on UFC Fight Pass. Also, we'll be live for the GLORY numbered series, GLORY 49, on ESPN3, which will re-air in the United States on ESPN2 at 9 p.m. on Sunday night. It's been a great 2017 for GLORY, our biggest year yet. Next year, even bigger. We've got exciting plans. We'll be heading to China, hopefully two different times. Also, we're going to expand into a new market we've got on the schedule coming up this year in April. We're going to be headed to Brazil. So we're going to South America for the first time. We just signed a big television package down there with Fox Sports. So we're really excited to head down to South America this year, or next year rather. Also, our first big event in 2018 will be GLORY 50, a true landmark show for us, our 50th GLORY card. That'll be in Chicago. We had a pre-sale a few days ago. All the tickets sold out immediately. So we're releasing new tickets soon. So for those of you watching in the United States and in the Windy City area, if you'd like to come to GLORY 50, we'd love to have you downtown Chicago. That's February 16th for GLORY 50. All right, let's get this party started. Tim, let's get these weigh-ins going.
All right, Todd, thank you. Todd Grisham. Joined by Whitney Miller and Joseph Valtellini on the play-by-play call tomorrow night from Rotterdam, our first visit to Rotterdam. And if you can't tell, there are a lot of smiles on the faces of all the GLORY staff as we get ready for 2018 and lots of things that are coming. But tomorrow night, it's all about a big finish to 2017. What a card it's going to be. 14 fights plus two undercards. So it's going to be a huge night of kickboxing, the biggest of the year. And marking the return, of course, of Nicky Holtzkin onto the GLORY card. We always look forward to him being with us. We will have our first defense of the middleweight belt with Alex Pereira putting his belt on the line. And then, of course, the one everyone's looking forward to, the main event, the heavyweight championship of the world, Jamal Big Ben Sadiq, here to take on the king of kickboxing, Rico Verhoeven, who is with us here today. We'll get started with the undercards first. Let me bring up Ramon Dalder from our talent operations department. He will oversee our undercard weigh-ins. Rafael LaRose is also here with us. Raffles, thank you for being with us. And the first two fighters up onto the stage, and they'll be the first ones on the scale today. Mirko Moisar taking on a last-minute addition to the card, Anis Karkach. Mirko Moisar onto the scales first. .70 for Mirko. And Anis Karkach, we're happy to have him with us for this first bout tomorrow night in Ahoy in Rotterdam. Comes in with 19 career wins. One loss, 10 of those wins by knockout. .69 for Anis. And that's the way things will get started as soon as the doors are open tomorrow at Ahoy. And again, we're expecting a sold-out card tomorrow night. And the second and final of our undercard fight, Samir Boukidous taking on Ramon Bont. Samir has been with us on a couple of prior occasions, not his first time on the GLORY card. 93.6 for Click Click, Loki Deuce. And Ramon Bont, his opponent. After the undercard, of course, we're going to flip things a little bit. Normally, we would start our evening with a super fight series. Tomorrow night, it is Glory 49 that kicks things off, and that means the four-man lightweight contender tournament will be first up. Let me bring up our Glory girls, however, so that they are here in front of everyone. Alyssa, Gemma, Stephanie, and Bella, all with us today. And then a familiar face, certainly to Glory fans all over the world, but this part of the world needs no introduction for our next guy. Mr. Core Hemmers is always with us to oversee our talent operations and, of course, oversee the weigh-ins.
And I think to myself,
we'll begin with the lightweight contender tournament in the first semifinal. Nicholas Larson and Tijani Bastati. Nick coming to us from Copenhagen, Denmark. His professional record, 47 wins, 9 losses, 2 bouts scored even. The Danish destroyer with 25 career knockouts. 69.2 for Larson. He was with us in Paris at Glory 42 earlier this summer, a WKU Muay Thai world champion. And then Tijani Bastati, representing Morocco on the scales today. Impressive professional record so far. 14 wins with just 1 loss, and 5 of those wins by knockout. He's undefeated in the Glory ring in 4 prior appearances. 69.4 for the Wonder Boy. That's just the first semifinal. We'll have them stay with us as we bring up the other half of the bracket. Michael Yerk taking on Stoyan Koprovlensky. Yerk to the scales first. Here from Curitiba, Brazil, 11-8 on a professional career with 7 knockouts. This will be his 4th Glory appearance. 69.2 for Yerk. He was also with us in Paris at Glory 28 and won his Glory debut over Shane Oblonsky all the way back at Glory 26 here in Amsterdam. His opponent fighting out of Bulgaria, Koprovlensky, 7 wins, 1 loss, 3 of those wins by knockout. A world amateur Muay Thai champion. For Koprovlensky. Fighting out of Bulgaria, he is making his first appearance in a Glory tournament. We got all 4 of our tournament contenders up here. And get a look at the certificate and, of course, the Ramon Decker's trophy that is up for grabs tomorrow night. I've been saying all this week that this card really is about past, current, and future world champions. Glory Sports International, the place where kickboxing true world champions are crowned. And one of these guys will move himself into contention for a shot at the lightweight championship of the world. Next up, it is the welterweights. A couple of guys making their debuts from different parts of the world. First, Anying Wong is here out of Xi'an, China, and he'll be taking on Omar Moreno. I'm a nomad, I'm a warrior, I'm a settler, I'm a Todd mentioned the Glory will be making our return in 2018 to China. Wong comes in 10 wins with 3 losses, making his Glory debut, trained in Sanda and Muay Thai. 76.3 for Onying Wong, who, by the way, appeared in the 2014 Ultimate Fighter and has made a couple of appearances in the mixed martial arts world on the big stage of the UFC. His opponent, Omar Moreno Marciano, 25-7-1 with 9 career knockouts. He comes in on a 3-fight win streak. Get your chest blown. 76.3 for Moreno, telling us yesterday he was born or originally came from Chicago, but has lived all over the world, including Thailand. Then we go back to the lightweight division. Couple of very promising prospects here. Samuel Petya will be making his very much anticipated debut, taking on Christian Baya. Petya from a beautiful spot in the world, Ljubljana, Slovenia, and brings a professional record, 35 wins, 6 losses, 1 draw, 23 of those wins by knockout. 69.5 for Petya, a 3-time Slovenian Muay Thai national champion. His opponent, Christian Baya. Baya, one of the real up-and-coming talents. Fighting out of Angola, of course, training and living here in the Netherlands. 59-5-1. He's undefeated in 3 prior Glory appearances. 69.2 for Bad News, Baya. He's a contender tournament champion and had wins over Masao Glunder and Anatoly Moiseev in Paris at Glory 42. That one could have Fight of the Night written all over it, and that one will be followed by the finals of our contender tournament and put a wrap on the Super Fight Series, Glory 49, leading us into the Super Fight Series tomorrow night at Rotterdam Ahoy. We'll take a short break to reset the canvas and get things ready for Glory 49 Super Fight Series. Jamie Bates and Ivan Dannenberg will get the Super Fight Series started in the welterweight division. The United Kingdom and Aruba being represented here. Jamie Bates to the scales first. Fighting out of the UK, 24 wins, 6 losses, 3 of those wins by knockout. He won his Glory debut in Copenhagen over Richard Abraham. 76.3 for Bates. And then another one of those great young talents, Ivan Dannenberg. Mr. Cool, 25 wins, 6 losses, 13 of those wins by knockout. He last appeared here in Amsterdam at Glory 45 with a win over Wellington Uega. For Ivan Dannenberg. Then we've got back-to-back heavyweight contests coming your way. Brian Dawes steps in last minute to take on Anderson Silva. Dawes out of the Netherlands, 41 wins, 20 losses, and 2 draws. Trained in Muay Thai and kickboxing. 105.6 for Dawes, who dropped a light heavyweight at Glory 34 in Denver to take on Salo Cavallari. Anderson Silva, here from Sao Paulo, Brazil. Braddock at 41 wins, 17 losses, and one draw. 26 of those wins coming by knockout. Silva, a Brazilian national champion. 113.2. Braddock, by the way, coming off a win at Glory 41 in Den Bosch over Giannis Stafaridis. We'll stay in the heavyweight division as D'Angelo Marshall steps in to take on Ismael Lant. Curaçao, Suriname, here stepping onto the world stage. U.S. Marshall, 16-2 with 9 career knockouts, a contender tournament champion after defeating Mohamed Abdallah and Anderson Silva at Glory 41 in Holland. 108.4 for D'Angelo. His opponent, Ismael Lant, and it's great to have him back inside the Glory ropes. It's been about a year since we've seen Ismael. 39 wins, 7 losses, 1 bout scored even, and 18 career knockouts. He, too, is a Glory Contender Tournament champion back at Glory 29 in Copenhagen. 120.9 for Ismael Lant. We then turn our attention to the welterweight division. This bout was scheduled to happen earlier in the year and got changed up, but we're thrilled that it's on the card tomorrow night at Ahoy. Alim Nabiyev taking on Nicky Holzken. Nabiyev stepping in from Azerbaijan, 47-6 with 21 career knockouts. The matchup was scheduled at Glory 45. He is an IFMA, WMG, WMC world champion. .76 for Nabiyev. And of course, he'll be taking on Nicky Holzken.
The time has come.
Ladies and gentlemen, prepare for
The Natural, 90 wins, 13 losses, and 46 career knockout. He is a former Glory welterweight champion. 76.8. Nicky telling us yesterday that he saw Nabiyev fight years ago and saw the talent in the young man.
Nicky, real quick, your fans are here. You had a lot of support, obviously, a lot of media here. I want to see what you have prepared. Back-to-back losses for the first time in your Glory career. What have you changed in the last 6 months since we've seen you?
I take some rest more and just training very hard. Have new training partners. And, back with my feet on the ground and train very hard and try to become world champion again.
Back-to-back split decision losses. Are you with a new mentality now? Are you thinking you have to knock people out?
Yeah, it's on me going knock out on my opponent.
Right. Good luck. Nicky Holzken, everybody.
Then it is the main event of our Super Fight Series. 5 rounds for the middleweight championship of the world. The first title defense for Alex Poatan Pereira taking on Yusri Belgari. This is actually a rematch from Glory 40 in Copenhagen. Look at the challenger up onto the scales first. He comes in as the number one contender out of Tunisia. Belgari, 23-3 with 11 career knockouts. He's on a 4-fight win streak, including a win at Glory 45 over Jason Wilnes. 84.5 for the challenger. And then the champion. Alex Pereira, here from Sao Paulo, Brazil. Poatan became a contender tournament champion in his debut, actually, at Glory 14 Zagreb in 2014. Won the belt in Guangzhou, China, with a dominant performance over then-champion Simon Marcus. 85 kilos even for the champ. Expect fireworks in this one. And then we'll take a brief break and get ready for Glory Redemption on pay-per-view showing around the world. And what a night it's going to be to wrap things up this way. We'll start with the featherweights. Zakaria Zuhari taking on Petpanamun Kiatmukau. Zuhari going to be fighting in front of his hometown crowd. And boy, is he looking forward to this in Rotterdam. 30 career wins, 3 losses, 1 draw, and 15 career knockouts. 64.8 for Zakaria. Undefeated in 2 prior Glory appearances. And then Petpanamun fighting out of Buriram province of Thailand. Crazy professional record, 157 wins, 36 losses, 2 draws, and 25 career knockouts. He, too, is a contender tournament champion back at Glory 39 Brussels, a 2-time world Muay Thai champion. 64.6 for Petpanamun. Then it's the featherweights. Bailey Sugden here to take on Chen Long Jong. Everyday man's on the block. Bailey, one of 2 represented on this card out of the UK, fighting out of Newark, England, a part of the Sugden fighting family. 10 wins with 1 loss as a professional. Bad boy with 2 knockouts on that career as well. He was a finalist in the Road to Glory UK 8-man tournament. Rice Krispies. Whole time I get with me. 64.3 for Bailey. His opponent here all the way from Shenzhen, China. Chen Long Zhong. 50 professional career fights, 45-5 with 11 knockouts, and has yet to be defeated inside the Glory ring at 3-0. He had a good showing in the Asian qualifying tournament in Guangzhou at Glory 46, won it with wins over Masaya Kubo and Quade Taranaki. 64.8 for Zhong. Bailey's had some dental work since we last saw him. Then the light heavyweights. Daniel Ilunga taking on Michael Duke. This is the 3rd meeting between these two. The last one, who could forget, happened at Glory Collision a year ago in Oberhausen. Fight of the year. Two of our favorite guys. Debuba Ilunga. Fighting out of Germany by way of the Congo. 57 wins with 14 losses, 44 career knockouts. He's going to enter the Glory ring for the 13th time. 94.4 for Ilunga, always smiling, but dead serious when it comes to taking on people like the Dream Crusher, Michael Dute. Oh, Dude fighting out of the Netherlands, 42-8 with 19 career knockouts. He is coming off of two knockout performances at Glory 45 here in Amsterdam, a contender tournament champion. 94.4 for Michael Dude, who's made a habit of living and dying by the sword. I think the average fight time for his career bouts is just under 4 minutes. And then we'll wrap up the biggest night for Glory in 2017 and one of the biggest nights ever for kickboxing with your main event, five rounds for the Glory Heavyweight Championship of the World. Jamal Ben Sadiq taking on Rico Verhoeven, a rematch of a fight more than 6 years in the making. Let's get the challenger up onto the scales first. Big Ben Sadiq, representing Morocco and fighting by way of Greta. Jamal comes in 32-5 with 26 career knockouts. He's on a 5-fight win streak, including a win over Guto Innocentia, Glory 39 in Brussels. 119.8 for Jamal. And then it's the king of kickboxing, Rico Verhoeven, back to again defend the Glory belt.
What you got when Rico makes the beat drop?
Rico, 52-10 with 15 career knockouts. He is on a 14-fight Glory winning streak dating back 5 years, five successful defenses of the belt. ...116.9 for the champ. It's going to be, and the place will be rocking tomorrow night in Rotterdam. Rotterdam, ahoy, a sold-out crowd. You can try and get tickets. Call the ticket office. We'll see you there tomorrow night. The world is going to be watching. Amsterdam, it's time for Glory!
Saturday, December 9th. Rico! It's Jamal Big Ben Sadiq.
I beat him once, he's nothing.
Taking on Rico, the king of kickboxing, Verhoeven, for the heavyweight title.
Yeah, it's redemption.
Glory Redemption, Saturday, December 9th. Don't miss it.